We're just going to do it like this instead. All right. Oasis here again. Hey, everybody. So I realized with the help of a few of my viewers that I have missed some very important information from my Procreate video on how to make emotes and or sub badges for your Twitch streams. I'm just going to fill in on that forgotten information and we'll go from there. I want to have a little disclaimer. You know, I wish I didn't have to, but it seems like that a lot of times you have to tell people this. I am not an expert on Procreate. I am actually very new at Procreate. I have had my iPad for many months, but I don't use it that often because I mostly work on my computer with my Wacom tablet and mostly using Affinity Photo. I used to do Photoshop and then I switched. I knew that with Procreate, because it was a digital program, that would make sense that you could make emotes with it. So I figured I would look into it and make an emote, and it worked. And there are some crucial information things that I did leave out because at the time, I was unaware that those things existed. If you ever have any other questions, you can always come watch me live on Twitch. I do stream every Monday and Thursday. You can come and talk to me live, ask me questions, see me draw emotes and other artwork, or just hang out. We have a lot of fun and chat and all that kind of stuff. I'll have a link in the description below. And also, you can join my Discord if you want to talk to me a little bit more one-on-one. That way you can come into the community and join in the fun there and join in with other artists and other cool people. All right, so let's get on with this. So what we're going to be doing today, on my last video, we talked about making emotes in Procreate, and I just talked about how you can use the program to draw emotes. I didn't do anything else about what it meant to save in Procreate or anything like that to shrink down and put them up on Twitch. I didn't know any of that because I hadn't actually tested any of that. And so what we're going to be doing is showing what we can do with the program this time. It's been brought to my attention by several people that when you try to resize a PNG file to a smaller size, it pixelates really bad. It just doesn't look clear. And so I did some testing and I figured out the issue. I will go through that in this video, so stick with me. A lot of people also asked about canvas size, that I forgot to mention or show what canvas size and dots per inch that I was using. So I'm just going to go quickly into that right now. Basically, you open up the canvas here. What I've done is if you look down here at the bottom, you can see that there's a untitled canvas. That's a canvas that I've already created in the past. But if you wanted to create something new, you would come up here to new canvas, and then you can create whatever size you want. If you want it to be 500 by 500, that's what I used. You can go smaller, you can go larger. It doesn't really matter that much. What actually matters more is the detail that you put into the emote, or rather the simplification that you need to have in your emote making, because if you put too much detail, it'll get completely lost when you resize. You can do a 500 by 500, and I have a 300 DPI. I really like how it makes it a lot smoother, especially when you resize. And then you can create. Since I already have one, I'm just gonna go ahead and open up a new one, and then we'll just go from there. And other people have asked me, what brushes did you use? And in all honesty, I didn't use any special brushes. Cat hair all over my screen. I just used the default brushes. I actually haven't downloaded any special brushes from Procreate. I do know that there are some out there that you can buy from other artists. And there's also, I believe I've been told that there are free options that people have uploaded somewhere. I actually am not aware of where those places are exactly, but there are many artists that do offer packs that they release for people. There's plenty of them on Instagram. You just have to go locate them. But since I haven't downloaded any, I can't recommend any to you. So I'm just using the basic ones that come with it. And there's like a lot that actually come with the program. So that's actually pretty awesome. So I usually sketch with a pencil brush. You don't have to. That's just my preference. I know some people that like to sketch with like a soft airbrush look. Again, it's all up to preference. I like it because it looks like a brush. I actually just got a couple of cats a few weeks ago. They are currently 4 months old and they're adorable, brother and sister. And yes, we're gonna get them fixed. And so why not? We're gonna draw a kitty emote. Why not? So something simple. And like I said, simple is very, very important when it comes to emotes. You don't want to be overly complicated, because if you put too much into it, it'll just get completely, utterly lost. So as you can see, this is a little bit smaller than the canvas, so you can always go ahead and actually resize it. And there's, you know, you can always change things. And if you don't want it to fill the canvas, because when I'm working on my computer, I actually have like a smaller box that is inside the actual canvas size, and I work with inside that box to say that that'll be the final size, and then I just use the outside of the box as like the bleed through of the rest of the emote. It actually became quite useful to have it that way. All right, so as I said before, you don't really have to go in and do all the cleanup, but a lot of the times when it comes to emote, you really want to have a nice like line that you can follow when you do the inking part, unless you're somebody that doesn't have to ink. I have to sketch. You do have to ink. I mean, you could probably leave it as a sketch. It probably would still be accepted by Twitch. They're not very picky. If you're the type of artist that can just sketch or draw something simple with a line and you don't feel that you have to sketch beforehand, then more power to you. That is definitely not me though. I have to have a sketch to follow. All right, so we have a finished emote here. Well, mostly finished. It's not shaded, but that's not too big of a thing. We can throw some very simple soft shading. I really like using soft shading. I think that it brings a little bit more to the character than like a hard edge. I know a lot of people like the harder edges, which is called cell shading, but I personally like the soft. Now, what we would be doing is trying to figure out how to resize it. Oh, sorry, I'm just stretched there. So you notice how one of the things that I did here is I was very simple. I did a very simple head, ears, eyes, mouth, eyebrows. You can go in and add more thick line art if you want. I would even recommend making it thicker. I didn't make it very thick, and actually I'm gonna leave it like this for now. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna see what will happen when it is resized, when the line art is so thin. You can test it by just shrinking it down yourself. It doesn't look too bad in this particular character because of the fact that it is a dark face with a contrasting eyes, but I don't know if it doesn't really look like the expression shows up very well. So I'll probably have to go in and add some highlights around the mouth, thicken the eyebrows, maybe even make them a white instead or a light gray instead of a black to make them stand out more. That's also a very good way of doing it, because they have to stand out. Of course, real cats don't have eyebrows, I know. What we would do, I think, yeah, hide the background color so it is now transparent, and then we just save the, maybe if I do this correctly. And then we save it. What we do to save is we just go ahead and we say share, and we want to save it as a PNG, and exporting, and then we say, who are we going to export? And so I just say, just save image. So now we have our PNG file, and now we want to resize. So one of the things that's interesting that I found about this is it's kind of weird, and I think it's something that Procreate needs to work on, the way that their system handles resizing, just because it jumps weird. But I actually had this problem in Photoshop. If I was at a larger canvas and I shrank down the image to something small from something large, it pixelated terribly. I actually had to make sure that I was saving it in a particular format. It actually needed to be by cubic in order to shrink down and not look like a horrible mess. What we do here is you come in here and you say canvas and you say crop and resize. You don't want it to actually crop. So what we're gonna do is resample the canvas. So if I go from 500 to 500 and I just go automatically to 1/12, now you can see when it resizes and fills in the canvas, it is huge. Now when you go down, it doesn't look that bad when you shrink it down at 1/12. But if we take the 1/12 at this very pixelated look and we resize again to the next size down for Twitch emotes, which is 56, it gets more pixelated. Crop and resize 28, and you go to 28 and you say done, then it looks very pixelated and very strange. And even if I shrink it down, it just loses all of the details that were there before. Even if they were very simplified, it looks very blurry and weird, and people have had this problem. What I ended up discovering, that I had to do this in steps, okay, which I get annoying. Okay, so we go 500,
400,
400,
300,
300, 200. See, it doesn't look that bad at 200, right? See how it wasn't as, it's not as pixelated yet? If I go from 200 now to 112, there's a clear difference than this was, than what was previously done from 500 to 112. These edges are much smoother. They're not as pixelated. They're not as sharp. The sharpness makes it lose all of its niceness, the nice smooth look. It's still pixelated, and that's completely normal because it's a 112. A 112 is not meant to be seen in this canvas size. This canvas size is too big. So this is the more of the real actual size that you'd be looking at it, and that looks perfectly fine. So if you go from 112 now down to 56, again, it doesn't look too bad. Also, it's still gonna look pixelated because, like I said, it's not meant to be viewed at that size. It's meant to be viewed more like this. And then you go from here to 28. It still looks pixelated. I know, I get it. I'm totally aware. But when you zoom out and you look at it, it looks like a bat. I mean, it doesn't look so bad. It looks like a bat. I made a cat bat. That's not bad. Bats are cool. This particular is a good example. I think one of the things that this one's struggling with is that it needs thicker lines and it will look nicer, I think, and more defining of the face with the features like the eyebrow because of the darkness. It needs more pop to it. So it needs contrasting. So you can't really tell the eyebrows are doing anything because it's not the right line thick. So one of the things that you should do, I recommend doing, is making a backup. Once you're done with your emote, save a copy of that file so you don't accidentally, either if you delete it or if you combine everything together and you no longer have all of the layers, you still have another file that you can fall back on in case you need to do edits. Like this needs to have more lines. I can do the outlines on this PNG. Sure, I could edit if I wanted to on the PNG, but it's kind of a pain in the butt, so I don't recommend that. However, once you're satisfied with your emote and you're said, you know what, it's great, I love it, I don't care, we're gonna move on, you can also go to Twitch and they have a auto resize feature on their emotes, on their upload page. It's only available for emotes, however, it isn't available for badges. So this trick that I just showed you about resizing in small increments will work for the badge as well, because the badges are even smaller than emotes. So you have to take that into consideration too. Simplify, keep everything simple, make your line art thicker than I did. That was my mistake. Don't make your cats look like that. And go ahead and try both. Resize it on here, resize it on Twitch, see what you like better. I've actually used Twitch's resizing feature and I like it. I think it does a really nice job. I haven't tried to see what it looks like if you try, because you can upload up to, I think, a 2300 pixel by 2300 pixel size. I haven't tried anything larger than a 400 or 500 pixel emote. That's as big as I get. I have never drawn anything bigger than that. I don't recommend, especially when you're new, because you can get caught up with this over detailing because you have so much canvas and it's so easy to do. If you keep it small, then you force yourself to keep everything simple until you get into the habit of being simple. Because there are some people that I know that I have seen that are very good at creating simple drawings, even when they're very large, because they make them very large so they can make merchandise off of whatever it is that they've made. Stickers, prints on shirts, prints on paper, and it's so they use a very large canvas, and then when they shrink it down to like a sticker size, it looks very nice and crisp. But they draw it very, very simplified on a big canvas. So I hope that these little tips have helped you. I hope that you understand that I'm not an expert on Procreate. I'm still learning a lot of tricks of the trade on it. It's a very cool program. It still has some things that need to improve, like the resize feature, for example, but they were not taking into account the idea of making emotes with Procreate. So I don't fault them for not thinking of resizing to the itty bitty emote sizes and resizing easily, right? So I don't fault them for that. It's just something I think that they could do a little bit better in their UI to figure out how to make resizing a little nicer. Either way, these should be helpful for you. Hopefully, if you have any more questions, like I said, hop into my live stream. I stream on Mondays and Thursdays in the evening time, usually around 8 p.m. Pacific time. And you can also always jump in my Discord. I am always on my Discord, unless, of course, you know I'm sleeping. Feel free to leave feedback in my comments section. Hit that like and subscribe button. Ask me any questions you have more about what you saw in this video or my previous Procreate video. Thank you so much for being here, and I hope to see you again. Later, nerds.